everyone. Welcome to Get Ready with me, Louise. So today we are going to go outside of our comfort zone and we are going to be playing with lots of colors. As you can see by my lips with the hot pink, I'm not so sure I chose the right color on that one. I don't know. But anyway, this is the eye look I created using the Raw Beauty Kristi and Pure palette in the colorful side, which looks like this. I don't know how long it took me to create this look. I forgot to look at the time because I did want to see how long it did take me to create it. Because I don't have that much time in the day to be really like taking a long time with my makeup. So I do like to see how long it does take me to do looks just because I don't have the time. So I know if I ain't got the time, I can't do that look. And of course, generally, I'm not walking around with this look anyway, but I just wanted to know. But anyway, I do see how I could incorporate some of these colors from the neutral into the neutral side and just give me a pop of color, you know, if I felt colorful, so to say. So I do feel like I can do that with this side. Did she create it for people that, aren't necessarily experienced with makeup and get intimidated or overwhelmed? Absolutely. The way she did it, it was perfect. I had troubles kind of with the neutral side just because like those aren't the shades I go to in a sense, or I think I was just so trying to use all the colors at once for you all. But I have created other looks just using like three colors or two colors and it turned out fine. So I don't have a problem with the formula at all, being somebody that doesn't know anything about makeup. So if you bought it as just like, you know, supporting her, or if you like the color scheme and you're new at makeup, you'll be fine using it. Just, you know, don't get overwhelmed, I guess. But we're going to go ahead and get started. So the first color I'm going to dip into is Side Effect, and I'm going to use my Sigma E25 to do that. And I really kick off the color because these are very pigmented. And I'm just going to start to create my crease. I'm going to use this as my crease color transition shade. Sort of just placing it right now where I want it, and then I'll start to blend in a minute. And again, I am not a makeup artist, so don't. If I done something wrong or I used the wrong brush, I mean, you'll know. So if I mess up or something, like, it may not be the palette's fault, it could be more my fault. I also lined my eyes with the white ColourPop eyeliner. I think it's in Exit. I'm pretty sure it is. Okay. Now we just blend. The blending isn't that bad, really, but it does take some work, I'm not gonna lie. Kind of went in a little bit heavy-handed on this eye. Like the other eye, I really went slow with it. building it up type of thing. I hope that you're able to hear me better with that mic. I know the AC's in the background, but I'm hoping that mic picks me up more so than the AC anymore. I don't really know yet if it's working or not, so I hope it is, though. So, because I don't edit these videos, I don't want any kind of, I don't want you to think that I've done something and you didn't see it. So I just start to finish. If there's a mess up, there's a mess up, you know? And there is so many techniques that you can do to apply makeup, so, I mean, you don't necessarily have to do this particular technique, because it's probably not even a technique, really. But you get to see the shadows regardless. And then I connected that pink, I took it under the lash line and connected up in there. I'll go back in later, though. I just want it, you know, there so I can see what I'm doing. Not that I really know where to go, but you know what I mean. But, I mean, it doesn't take, the blending's what takes the longest, to be honest. Especially when you're, you know, just going slow, very slow, so you don't mess up, you know? Alright, I think I got it the same. Oh, I did use the Hourglass Veil Primer also. All right, so then the next shade I went into was the E27 with blah, 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 blah. See? The next shade I went into was Tribute, and I used the Sigma E27. And I thought this would be good for, like, the outer corner. The V. So I laid it down there. And then I started to blend out. This one here took me a little bit of time, but I hear purples are hard to formulate to begin with. But I think it just took me so long because I am not makeup artist. You know what I mean? Get back in a little bit. There's more. You can see the blending. It is blending, and it's blending good with the previous color and all. Like, it's blending into that nicely. It's just taking me a long time to blend. Which, again, could be because I'm not a makeup artist, or I don't have the right tools, or using the wrong tools for that matter. Like I said, it did take me a while to get the purple to go. Now, after that, it was, you know, easy. The pink wasn't hard either. I mean, it was a little bit, but not much, really, but... make sure that I get it. That's the other thing, like when you do one eye first, you're not for sure on, you know, making them look the same. hell's everybody doing? So the sale or the pre-sale for this palette is over. Did anybody buy to purchase it, or do you already have it? Have you played with it? Like, I'm curious if everybody's, you know, doing good with it, or having any issues, or just any kind of issues, like just trying to, you know, figure out the colors you want to choose. Or what looks good on them, and what doesn't, type of thing. Now I'm going to take a, what did I do? All right, this is where I went in. I went back into side effect, and I'm just using a real technique shader brush. And I'm going to darken up that line there. Maybe not that dark. Then I took a Real Technique, or no, an EcoTool liner smudger, and went back into Tribute, which is the purple, and I'm going to smear that under my lower lash line, right, kind of right up against it. It up into that pumpkin. Like that. Alright, let's see. I think I need to take that from water just to tab in now. So give it a little more form tribute. I'm just gonna pat it right about there. And there's no fallout. There's just some kickback in this, but so far I've had no fallout, which is pretty cool, because I do my face makeup first, so that works out for me. And then it looks like that eye. Alright, I'm going to go back in with the first brush that had side effects on it. I don't have anything else on it, but I'm just going to go ahead and blend these two together. Make sure it all looks nice. As nice as I can get it anyway. And knowing what I'm doing, so I have no idea how to find it. Flying by the seat of my pants most of the time. I do enjoy playing with color though. I had a lot of fun doing that other eye, like just sitting there playing with it, figuring it out. Like, it was kind of fun. I can't deny that. Then I went in with, I went into Garden State. And I laid it right beside the purple. And I used a, E20, which I'm sure is not the brush to use. But I was just like laying it down right beside it. And then I took a E45 and just sort of like blended it, I guess. What you call it? I'm so good, aren't I? But this is what I'm talking about. This is just from a, I'm just a consumer. So that way you get to see, you know, if you don't have experience, what it can do. Or, you know, how you may do it. Or maybe not. I'm starting to think I'm the only consumer out there that don't have any experience in makeup. Then I go back into the purple, or no, the pink. I go back into the pink. And then back into the purple to make sure, that blue didn't get too carried away there. I mean, and they blended together nicely, you know? I don't know if you can see that or not, but I think they blended together nicely. Then I took a... that's nice. Stuck my finger right in there. Then I took my... Is it this one? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to use it too. Okay, hold on. Not always something. Seriously. See? There is something else. It's always something. We'll talk about the mascara in a minute, too, because I didn't have fun with that at all. Alright, then I'm going to take the E56 by Sigma, and I'm spraying it, and I'm going to go into Cafe Disco. This is an amazing color. This shimmer, oh my goodness. I'd go into this palette just for the shimmer. I kid you not. It is such a pretty color. And it does go so well with these, you know, rainbow colors. Then I decided, well, since I had done all of that, I wanted to try out that Hurtful. So I decided to line my upper lash line and bottom lash line with it. And I'm using, where's something on that? I don't know what's on, but anyway. I'm using the Sigma E65. I actually like this color too. And all of these colors are so pigmented. Like, it's so crazy. It really, really is. You wouldn't think it. Well, I mean, you would think it. You would hope it. You know, being that you see it in the palette, you hope it comes out that color, and it really is. It's really true color. And then I'm going to do the same to the lower lash line. So that's what I did with the palette. Now, mascara. I bought two new mascaras, the Pat McGrath and the Hourglass new mascaras. I used the Pat McGrath yesterday. I decided to use the Hourglass today. I don't even know where I put it. The Pat McGrath didn't flake on me or anything like that. Didn't, you know, it's a mascara. This one, Hourglass. Hold on and I'll show you. Let me curl my eyelashes really quick. So this one's called Unlocked. Should have stayed locked. And I love Hourglass. There's not much from them I don't like, but so far this is not my cup of tea. Of course, it's my first time using it, so maybe it has to sit. I will say it definitely... Wait. Coats each lash. And I think this would be good for like my bottom lash line, but not my top. Because even though it coats each lash, it doesn't do anything else. Like, I don't know if you can see, like, it really doesn't do anything. It doesn't give me length, other than it coats each lash. That's it. Which I think, if I'm not this, I think this could be a 2D mascara. I'm not for sure. In which case, I do like this for my bottom lash line. So if that is, you know, if this is all it does, then this is what it, you know, this will definitely be a lower lash line type of mascara. So that's the final look, and this is using the Hourglass, like I said, first time using it. It may need time to sit. I know a lot of mascaras do need that. I didn't nick myself. I was like, I know I nick myself. I always did. Alright, there you go. So, I mean, all in all, I don't mind the mascara, but it's not my favorite. But I think it could be my favorite for my bottom lash line. So it's a possibility. I'll keep more up to date with it as I play with it. But these are, you know, this is the look I created. I used, and I did lay down the white also on top of once I put the primer down, I used Lumos. I don't know what that word is, but it's the white one. And I use that as sort of the setting powder to it, just to, you know, because it's easier for me to blend the shadows if I have a powder down. So I did apply the white very, very lightly. Then I went in on colors. So technically I used 6 of the 9 shadows on the colorful side doing this look. And I actually think it turned out really, really good, especially for somebody that has no experience. So with that said, I mean, I enjoy the palette. I think it's worth it. I hate when people do limited edition stuff, but I hope that if you had a chance to get it, you got it, because it is worth it. I'm just touching that up. Okay, sorry, I had to touch it up. But I hope you, if you had a chance, you got it, because I think you will like it. I think you'll be very surprised with it, actually. And I did hear that the formula is different than their regular pure palettes, which I don't know yet, because I forgot how the other palettes work. But I am going to play with them. I'm going to pull them out. I got the Barbie one. My daughter's got the Grinch one, but I'll just take it from her and get it back there with her. And I'm going to play with them and see if they are different. But other than that, I have no issues. I think she did a great job. I think as bad as 2020 has been for all of us, this is her year, and she so deserves it. I mean, if there was anybody on the platform that, like, really deserves something, it's her. And I enjoy watching her videos. But anyway, it's really good. So anyway, this is the final look. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and stay safe, and stay healthy, and I will see you then. Oh wait, first, hit the thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe, ring the bell, hit all, that way you're notified when I do upload videos. I try to do it regularly, just because it's just getting ready with me, you know. And I get ready almost every day, for the most part. Sometimes I don't, but most of the time I do. But anyway, stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.